because I think that's an unfair situation when during, after June 15th, that town dock comes back to taxpayers of Jamestown has their dock to use for their uses and access to their boats. So I think in good keeping with the past practices on that commercial property, I think it would be very important to enforce what has been happened in the past and not allow the cording off of the Dutch Harbor Boatyard property in any part. It's been a boatyard for a long time. It's had a combination of uses. It's worked in the past. It can work again, and I think they need to provide some parking. Basically, at this point, there's no parking provided on that commercial property. So I think that needs to get addressed in this. And if you're going to, again, the important thing for the ordinance would be to put something that's supportable, enforceable, because the one that we have clearly is not. So thank you.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I'd like to speak to the signage on Coronado Street.
Name and Paul Levesque.
I have a house on Coronado and Cross Street. And what's been happening last year, year and a half, with the large delivery truck parking next to the Jamestown Press, they're facing inwards towards Coronado Street. So they're trying to get out towards. So what's happening is these 20-wheelers coming down Coronado Street, come to Knowles Court. They can't traverse around the corner of Knowles Court. They continue all the way down. They get down to where I live at Cross Street and discover they either can't make that corner there, or they get out and pretend to have the neighbors move their cars so they can do that. So what happens? Now you get this 20-wheeler that's stuck way up at the end of Coronado Street. The only thing they can do is back up. We've had at least 15 trucks over the last year, year and a half, go all the way down Coronado Street and find out they can't make the turns. So what do? They're backing up. Now, we've got all types of young families on that road. Now, this big truck is backing up. Some little kid runs out, swish, gone. What I'm asking is that maybe some sort of signage be put up that says local, you know, trucks, local delivery only. And I don't know what you would do with the signage there on Coronado Street, because you're allowing the trucks to park inward. Therefore, parking on the sidewalk, they can't back out onto Narragansett Avenue. So now their only option is attempting to go all the way down, and they can't traverse the narrow roads, so now they're backing all the way up. So, you know, you're not enforcing that law. You're letting them park there, but you're not giving them get out. They can't, they're not going to go around from Shelby Hills. They're not going to get on Knowles Court. They can't turn at Cross Street. So, you know, and then they're backing down. So we get a tremendous safety hazard with these big trucks, allowing them, maybe you have them park the other way, or require them, if they're going to park there, have a smaller truck. There's no need to have these big 20-wheelers coming in, parking there on a sidewalk, prohibiting movement of traffic, and then trying to go through the neighborhoods and causing a tremendous safety hazard, especially with all the young families on that street. So I would like to have the town council or the administrator look at that and consider the signage of just allowing local delivery trucks through that down Coronado Street. Yeah.
A couple of things. I had written to the council. Cynthia Levesque. I had written to the council on August 10th.
Cynthia Levesque.
Cynthia Levesque for on August 10th, previous council, and I provided pictures of what was happening down the end of Coronado. August 10th, let's see, I gotta go back to my letters. But regarding this very situation, right, it's all this stuff, so I can't find it, but. It's 2 years ago, 2008. And I was basically, and other neighbors who complained at the time, because we knew that they were going to make a permanent loading zone at the corner of Coronado and Narragansett Avenue. They had approved a permanent loading zone because of this issue with the trucks and all this stuff. And so myself and other neighbors did complain. Nothing happened. Instead, they said they're still going to do it. And they gave them this opportunity. We did talk. At that time, myself and a couple of the neighbors to chop Miss Charlie's because we know of him. He's a pretty good business family, you know, and all that. And we asked him, please, don't have large trucks, or at least inform your trucks not to come up the street because they're not going to be able to make it. And he said he would. And for the most part, I believe he has, you know, tried to comply with that. He really is a very good businessman. And unfortunately, because there is no sign there, because there's nothing there explaining to a driver who has never been there, I mean, he's not going to catch everybody. It could be some driver dispatching something down the street. Who knows what it is? But he's not going to see everybody. And that's not humanly possible. So what you have to do is you have to alert the drivers to the conditions in the roads. And what I had suggested in two letters were, was a sign that would say local to the truck. You know, we have these signs that are, I forgot the term for them, but local delivery zone. Maybe something at the beginning of Coronado Street, maybe something at Knowles Court. Because if, and I have pictures which I can give you if you are interested. And do I give them to you? Okay.
Yep.
These kind of panel trucks, which are perfectly, I guess, okay, except the emergency vehicles can't get out of the, you know, the fire station when they're there. So in case somebody needs an emergency vehicle, and these are the pictures I had taken 2 years ago, and this is the same condition. She had to go liquor pictures. I'm sorry, it was just so happened that day. I went out of dry town. But anyway, obviously, but anyway, it certainly is something that needs to be addressed. And I think if we're not asking, and I'm not asking as a resident, the impossible that, as Mr. Kaiser stated, you know, well, we need to accommodate the public, but we also need to accommodate public safety. We also need to look at that. And we also need to look at the safety of the residents in the area. And we also need to be concerned about drivers who are telling people to move all their trucks. I mean, their own personal cars. Well, but these are small streets. This isn't, you know, the I-95 that we're talking about here. So there has to be accommodation made. And I'd like to say one other thing about trucks. In other communities, such as Newport and Providence on the east side, where they have smaller, older streets, the people who are making the deliveries are told to use smaller trucks. I think I've heard that mentioned here. They are given that mandate, kind of use smaller trucks, don't come up with 21-wheelers. You know, it's because it's not going to work in these small neighborhoods, in these small streets. They don't accommodate that. And for the most part, that works. They're also told to deliver during certain periods of time. I heard you mention that as well. And so that's another. So there are things that can be done. Just don't have to throw up our hands and say, well, let's have a 21-wheeler come through somebody's house one of these days, or kill a kid on a street, worse yet. I mean, is that enough? We cannot exit on Coronado Street. We cannot. We do not want to narrow things. Now, I agree with the other gentleman that previously wrote the letter, and I wrote a letter as well at that time. But we are concerned about public safety, if nothing else. I hope the council will take it under consideration of something to be done.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Bruce, on these items, are you going to come back later with revisions and write-ups or something that we can take action on?
Yes, and I appreciate the comment that Ms. Levesque has shared with us, and I hear him.
It's easy enough.
So it is a vexing issue, but somewhere some improvements can be achieved, I think. That's what
appreciate it. Thank you.
For clarification at this point, the council does not want an ordinance draft yet. You'd rather we work on this, and then once you make a policy decision, then draft the ordinance.
I mean, do you need an ordinance for a sign? I mean, I don't understand.
We already have that.
Yeah.
And for the
local deliveries only. I mean, which means UPS trucks, propane trucks, you know, obviously water trucks, they are coming up the street, but they all know the area. So they kind of, you
know.
Know
through traffic.
That's the other
issue. Any sign that has to go before the council.
Okay.
Okay. Well, I appreciate anything you can do, really.